Hey, welcome back everyone, JayBarino here, continuing the Gallantry, a custom campaign for StarCraft 1. Heading into map number 2, Twist of Fate. Now's the best time to join the military. Sure. Let's check it out.
Attention citizens of New Trestia. In compliance with new alcohol consumption regulations designed to reduce public rioting, all establishments serving alcohol will close for 3 hours prior to dawn, beginning now. If you are patronizing such an establishment, please leave at this time. You may return in 3 hours. Thank you.
Really? That was the briefing? We're cutting you off? All right. New Dresdia, Dorasida. Okay, so this is definitely part of Celestial Stories. We've got Dorasida.
Man, this new bar curfew thing bites. What am I supposed to do for 3 hours? The city sure has changed a lot lately. Everything's different. I haven't been around town for a long time. Guess I've been hanging around these bars for too long.
Attention job seekers. Do you find yourself with fewer and fewer credit chits? Unable to pay the rent on your condo? Then you need a job. Go to any of the courtesy job grubs in Eastern New Dresdia and select your career today.
A job. That might not be such a bad idea. Sure beats living on the streets.
Find the job booths in the Eastern District. Avoid police breathalyzer
Rain
blockades.
Lance, age 20. Let's go.
This is okay. Kim Wang, and you're listening to Hit Discs on Slam Radio.
Oh, Slam Radio, I've missed them.
Let's go.
Is it just going to be music, or are they going to be talking to us? Sounds like just music.
Yeah,
all right,
yeah.
Let's head over there.
Have you heard their rumors?
Oh, what have you heard, Javier?
Someone new is in town, apparently. The resident intel got hold of some reports from border patrols. Ships have gone missing. Mostly science vessels and freighters. And all the search parties find out traces of plasma energy. Very strange energy signatures. No one has seen their like in this sector.
Another ghost story, Javier? Get it? Ghost? I crack myself up.
Very funny, Dimitri. Easily amused. Hey, do you see that fellow over there in the green civilian tunic? He is staring at us. Do you know him?
Never seen him before in my life. He looks like a good man. Hey, comrade in the green! Come over!
Zachary, are you out of your mind, Dimitri? He could be a Dominion spy.
This paranoia is unhealthy, Javier. But I will indulge. Let us go somewhere else to finish talking.
Okay. This seems like this is very much a world-building mission if we're in New Dresdia and we're walking around as a civilian. And that's something that Desler's always really been into, is world-building. You know, New Dresdia, Allerites, all of these goofy little factions that he's created. I feel bad saying them. Goofy little factions. He's clearly put in a lot of thought and effort into them, so I suppose it's interesting that, you know, he takes the time to present these to us in this way. Anytime we're in New Dresdia, though, I notice it's like a long mission of just kind of walking around. We've had a few of these in the past, but we'll see. Usually these consist of sets of mini-games and lots of exposition, so that's basically what I'm expecting here. All right, here are the job booths. I'm thinking we can't use these ones because there's people on them. Or something is broken. I'm just going to assume that we'll go to the empty beacon. How about this?
Job. Waiter. Earn good money serving people's food. Wait on tables for people in the Ryman Steakhouse. Pay is maximum wage. We keep 80% of your tips. Apply now. 2242 Bond Street.
Well, as much as I'd love for them to keep most of what I earn, I think I'll keep on looking.
Job. Disc jockey. Radio station BRLA is looking for a motivated replacement for a former DJ. Pay is 40 credit chits per hour. More if ratings improve. Apply now. 425 Stuka Way.
I saw a story on this radio station on the news. The former disc jockey, he committed suicide after seeing Slam Radio's ratings. No other radio station in town can do well at all with Slam around. As much as I like public speaking, I don't think talking to an audience of two people is very fun. Pass.
Job. SCV operator. Working the mines of New Dresden's dank caves. Requires medical exam. Applicants must have good respiratory health. The weak lungs need not apply. Pay is 10 credit shifts an hour during training, and 15 per hour after training. Apply now. 7576 Industrial Avenue.
I don't think all that hard work is for me. Lugging those heavy Vespine gas containers gives you too much stress. I'd rather avoid that.
Oh my god.
Job. Military. Join the glorious Starkenped military. Diverse career selection. Marines, Navy, Space Command, Domestic Air Patrol, Military Police, Operations, Tactical Planning, and many more. Pay is 900 credit chips a week for new recruits. Benefits include free room and board, meals provided by the Dorasida Chef Corps, and generous pension package upon retirement. Join today and defend Dorasida. 4590 Tark Way, Recruitment Office.
Free room, free meals, and great bonuses after you retire? Oh yeah! I could be pretty happy doing that. Though I'll have to try to get aboard a space vessel, I can get some out-of-the-way job no one will notice. This is going to be great.
Find the Tarkenped Recruitment Center. Avoid police breathalyzer blockades.
Let's go.
Okay,
yeah.
So is it up here?
Okay.
I guess this is probably it. Or is that where we started? No. We're coming way over here right now. You know what I'm gonna do? Let's give it a shot. I'm gonna right-click on the beacon and let's see if we can path our way there without hitting one of these breathalyzer places. I don't even know what those are even gonna look like. So it'd be funny if it was like an instant loss if that did happen, so I'm gonna save just in case. Like I said, mostly just exposition at this point. It's possible that there's a lot of this map to uncover, so I expect a lot of jumping around on the map and, you know, possibly mini games. That's how these types of city maps have worked, and these are things that we've seen in campaigns such as the Antioch Chronicles, at least when, you know, the remake, and I assume if we were to ever play the original, it was a few missions inside of, like, a city. We've seen Legacy of the Confed, where the Oracle was actually trying to emulate Desler, and we had some missions on Dorasida, which was pretty cool. If you remember, we had the Keepers show up on Dorasida along with the Hunter Killers. So that was pretty cool, and that all makes way more sense now after playing Desler's campaigns. One thing I actually learned recently that I didn't realize for a long time is that Desler was actually the founder of Campaign Creations. I didn't know that. Alrighty, so let's... Oh god, is that the line? Find Wheezing Ernie in the Southern District. Avoid police breathalyzer blockades. I like how the guy said this couldn't get worse unless Wheezing Ernie showed up. And then without pause, the objective just said, go find Wheezing Ernie. Like, we didn't even have Lance think, like, huh, maybe I should go find Ernie, Wheezing Ernie. It's like, no, we're going to get him. We know exactly what we need. We want those sweet, sweet meals from the... Okay, I'm assuming that's one of the breathalyzer stations. Let's walk around
that.
I assume...
Nothing like a little stroll to clear your head.
We're gonna join the military.
All right. Yeah.
Because we want those sweet, sweet free meals from the Dorasida Chef Corps. That's right. They have the Chef Corps.
It ain't something, young little snapper. Want me to go and talk to some people in the recruitment center? Shuffling.
Blah. Return to the recruitment center. Sure. Let's just do this, and we'll see if he tries to path through the breathalyzer station, then we'll just make sure he goes around the other way. Nope, we're going the right way. You know, one thing while we're walking I want to point out is, have I been misunderstanding the... I think I have. For the longest time, up until this exact moment, for decades, I thought that every single Terran civilian was modeled such that they have a really unflattering ponytail. And now I'm realizing that's a vest. That's a brown vest.
anymore. Let's get out of here, guys. It can't be worth going through this to get into the military.
Standing in line for all day, huh? If that's the worst, you definitely don't fit in the military. Into the recruitment center. Yeah, so let's real quick, because now I'm fascinated with this. Is that a really unflattering ponytail? Because now I'm looking at it and it could be a backpack. Or it's a vest or a backpack of sorts. Because when you're looking at the side, it's kind of hard to tell. I'm thinking now I'm looking at everything completely different. This is so crazy. My entire worldview has shifted. I think that's a little backpack, a knapsack. Here we go.
What do you mean? I'm not eligible.
That's the rule. Now get out of here, you no good slacker.
You can't talk that way to me. You know who I am? I'm Devin Lowburn. You hear me? Devin Lowburn.
Devin Lowburn.
Sorry about that. We got a lot of weirdos to try to apply here. And your name?
Rain Lance, age 20.
Well, I didn't ask for your age, son. Now listen. First, I'm going to have to ask you a few questions before I can let you join.
Questions? Sure. Oh, hey, do I get to wear a cool uniform like that?
Well, yes. Eventually, when you,
Oh, man, that's great. Women really like a man in uniform, you know?
Yes, well, first of all, why do you want to be in the military?
Oh, yeah. I want to be in the military to serve our great planet, sir. That's a pretty cool flag. Think I could get one for my quarters when I join up?
Is this some kind of idiot?
1 week later.
Come on, recruit Lance. You're going to have to run around this base faster than that. You're slower than my grandmother's petroleum turtle. Now move it.
Hey, what's up with all the reporters hanging around here?
Oh, damn. They're doing one of their special reports on life in the military. You know, for the supplementary evening news and all that.
We are reporting live from one of Fort Lewdon's basic training fields. And standing behind me is Admiral Rick Marcel of Talking Pet High Command. Admiral, many of the senators are concerned about military recruitment being at an all-time low. What are your views on the situation?
Well, the public perception seems to be that we're not able to recruit people because potential recruits aren't motivated. Let me correct this misconception by pointing out the fact that our armed forces are currently very well staffed in terms of personnel.
Hey, recruits, you aren't allowed over there. Get back over here.
But various news agencies and internal government figures point out that several branches of the military are in demand, the Navy in particular. Many of its space vessels are being launched with reduced crew complements, and there is...
This is Admiral Marcel. Report.
Attention, citizens of New Dresden. This is an emergency announcement. An unknown armed vessel has been detected approaching the city. Seek shelter immediately.
Recruit, Hans, get the automated defense system now. Quick!
Huh? Oh, you mean this thing?
Yeah, this is Lieutenant Osborne over at New Dresden Control. We are reading Fort Loudoun Perimeter Defense Activation. Scrambling Wraith Fighters. Okay, Ivory Wing is inbound. ETA 40 seconds. Sit tight, Admiral. Our boys are coming.
I am invincible. Everybody's gotta die sometime, Red.
Oh, it's one of those things from Mission 1. That was it?
Amazing. Absolutely amazing. Jack, get the camera over here for a close-up. This man, this recruit has saved this entire military base and its personnel from certain disaster. So, can you give us your name?
Rain Lance, age 20.
Amazing. Admiral, what do you have to say about this fine young recruit?
Yes, well, any idiot can turn on the perimeter defense guns. Just pressing a button.
But these reporters don't know that. And recruitment is at an all-time low. Time to do a little public relations song and dance.
Why, this is amazing. This young man is a shining example of the courage and resourcefulness of Targumpad military personnel. Indeed, it is he and his fellow recruits who have made, and will continue to make, the Targumpad military so great. In fact, recruit, for your meritorious actions here today, I am personally offering you a field promotion to Captain. How does that sound?
Captain? Of what, sir?
Why, Captain of a space vessel in the Navy, of course.
That's great. I've always wanted to be a captain of a spaceship.
Any recruit or enlisted man or officer who displays this kind of selfless valor would also be given such promotions. Our military is based upon rewarding those who are the most dedicated and the most courageous and honorable in their service. It is the finest military organization you can join. Anyone else who decides to join our fine military will have the same opportunities as this proud young recruit.
That's right.
There you have it. This young man was a recruit, made a captain overnight. Admiral, can you give us any information about the attacking ship?
Ah, yes. Well, intelligence will have to study the sensor data collected in order to prepare a full report. However, in my military experience, I'm sure that this was just a scout vessel conducting reconnaissance when it entered our defense net. If you'll excuse me, I need to confer with my officers and link up with headquarters.
I feel like I'm watching a television show in StarCraft 1. What a thrill. 3 days later. 3 days later.
So, do you understand your mission completely, Commander? It is imperative that we ascertain the capabilities of these aliens. The captain has received mission details, and you will be informed on a strict need-to-know basis. Give it your best, Commander Green.
You'll get nothing less, Admiral.
I like this modified battlecruiser commander portrait. Well, there we are.
You wanted to see me, Admiral?
Ah, yes, Captain Lance. We have finally found a vessel in need of your command.
You're giving me that huge ship? You guys really treat your captains well.
Oh, no, we can't give you the Gallantry. It's on, special duty. We've got an even finer vessel suited for your talents.
That's the ship I'm getting assigned to?
Oh, Captain, come on now. Think of it as a challenge. I'd like you to meet your co-pilot and engineer, Giles Montgomery.
Morning to you. Damn hangovers. I need a drink.
You'll be transmitted your first assignment when you reach orbit. Due to your inexperience, I have taken the liberty of assigning one of our veteran officers to you. Montgomery is not quite the model officer, but he'll follow any order you give him. Bon voyage, Captain.
Well, they'd better give me some easy missions if all I get to command is a dinky little dropship. Maybe I can relax a bit when we get into space.
I know I'm able to relax during this entire mission because I don't have to do anything. I still can't control anything on the map, in case anyone was wondering. I don't think anybody was wondering. It's a very common thing that mapmakers used to use exploding Valkyries, exploding Wraiths, exploding Corsairs to signify like fireworks or celebratory explosions. It's pretty neat. So the Gallantry, I still don't really know what this thing is or what it's used for. There's only 4 total missions in this campaign, so obviously we're not going to learn too much before this was basically abandoned, but I'll look at the police manning their security checkpoints. Whoa! Launching into hyperspace. Oh, it's Desler. I just realized he's got his own little guy here. Okay. Oh, and that was it. Wow, so much of this map was unused. I apologize. Look, I am just the messenger. This map was, it is what it is. Okay? Okay. You know what? One thing we can take away from this, we learned something invaluable about the Terran civilian model in StarCraft 1, or at least I did, which I'm sure was very, very obvious to every other person for the most part. Did anybody else out there think that was just like a really shitty-looking ponytail? Like a really bad fashion choice for these men in the future in the Koprulu sector? That probably was just me. I don't know, but my mind is blown. Every time I see a civilian now in StarCraft, I won't be able to unsee it. Alrighty, well, this has been Jay Barino. Thanks so much for watching. When we come back, I assume we're going to have some mission with real gameplay. I'll see you then. Bye now.